celebrating 16 years of Young Turks.
Welcome back. You're watching Young Turks, India's longest-running show on entrepreneurship. On the show today, we've been talking about Pi Ventures, a $30 million VC fund that's solely focused on investing in AI and machine learning startups in India. Pi has so far invested in 4 startups, and while it's still early days for the fund, it's never too early to talk about exits, especially in India, where even in established domains, blockbuster exits have been few and far between.
We do 2 things differently in our fund. One is we are a very IP focused fund, so there is a lot of possibilities of mergers and acquisitions that can provide liquidity to the investors. We also are a seed fund. We are a very early stage fund, so there are possibilities of secondaries coming out in later rounds like B, C, D. Therefore, we can sort of return the capital to the investors by using some of those mechanisms.
And this ties in with what's happening globally. Crunchbase counted at least 40 acquisitions so far this year versus 56 in all of 2016. This in the AI and machine learning space. By comparison, as I pointed out, just 56 done in 2016. The deal size sweet spot for M&A stands at about $15 to $20 million. But who's leading the charge? Let's take a look at that. Intel has made 81 investments so far. Google's parent company, Alphabet, has made the highest number of acquisitions, coming in at 20. Moreover, Google, Microsoft and Toyota have together announced new AI-focused corporate venture funds. The team at Pi Ventures believes that this does bode well for the ecosystem in India, but startups must innovate and create world-class IP, not simply force-fit AI into a business model to try and raise funds.
You know, the 3 parameters that we actually look at, you know, in terms of a big no. One is like, you know, if what they're promising to do and they don't have the technology ability to actually follow through on that, especially on the AI and machine learning part, then it's a harder for us to say yes. The second part, which is a kind of red flag for us, are the entrepreneurs which are trying to force fit AI into their business model, because a lot of time it does not make sense, you know, especially if you're looking at, let's say you're trying to give recommendations based on image analysis, or you know, you're actually running very computationally heavy, expensive compute heavy, expensive algorithms on it, and that would probably make your cost per query really go up significantly, even at scale, right? So, you know, those models don't make sense to us. The third big no is, I think those there are some businesses which are very, very execution heavy. Funding could make a huge amount of difference. So some companies which actually have more capital, you know, those areas they could win. Those are the cases we stay away from.
Well, the story of Sigtuple is a good illustration of how Umakant's checklist comes together. Founded in 2015 by Rohit Pandey, Apurv Anand and Tathagato Dastidar, Sigtuple is a deep learning-driven blood diagnostics venture. The venture has now raised $5.8 million and counts Pi Ventures as one of its early supporters, even though they've invested only in the Series A round earlier this year. Let's take a look at their story.
2012, American Express brought three of us, the 3 co-founders together, myself, Tatha and Apurv, and they gave us the charter to set up the Big Data Labs team in Bangalore so that intelligent data products can be brought into the market. So 3 of us, we worked together for almost 2.5 years, completed our goals, delivered the products, and then we started looking for interesting opportunities. Healthcare industry caught our attention because of enormous amount of data it has, not only in form of numbers, but also videos and images. The other thing was there was a social impact opportunity associated with this.
The idea was simple, to create an intelligent data-driven model to analyze blood samples. Using freely available online data, a working model was made and shown to doctors. The early feedback was encouraging and Sigtuple was incorporated in July 2015, and then the uphill task of data collection began.
But our problem was even bigger, because the data which we had to use, it was not available in digital form. So when we started working on our first solution, which is for analysis of peripheral blood smear, what we realized that the data existed in form of physical slides. the digitization solution which were available in the market, they were very expensive. So the first hurdle was to come up with a low-cost digital scanner so that we can digitize data. So what we did, we took a standard light microscope used in a lab, added electromechanical components and mounted a cell phone and converted a normal light microscope into a digital scanner. Through this device, we started digitizing data and we started using this data for model training. So after the data was digitized, the second hurdle was how to get the data annotated, because in order to do model training, we needed an annotated data. So we onboarded pathologists who can annotate the data so that we can use it for our model training. Then we encountered the second hurdle. What we realized that there is a lot of inter-observer variability when it comes to annotation of data. So we figured out that between three pathologists, the inter-observer variability in the annotation was more than 30%. This means every time we uploaded a set of data for annotation, we had to discard 30% of data. This was the second problem which we had to solve before we start the model training. We solved this particular problem by building another intelligent model which can do a triaging so that we can get a significant amount of data for model training.
This product is not only a complete peripheral blood smear analyzer solution which automates routine tasks like differential counts, it also provides a screening solution for parasitic infections like malaria and disorders like anemia. The startup will begin commercializing this first product in the next quarter. Similar products for urine and semen analysis and retinal and chest scans are in advanced stages of development as well. All of this deep R&D and technology customization requires cash, and that proved to be a challenge till Sachin and Bini Bansal of Flipkart opened their purses.
Pcom science graduate without any healthcare background are willing to solve problem in healthcare by using something called AI, which is very new for the industry. So we reached out to Sachin and Bini Bansal. Obviously, they don't understand healthcare much, but they understand the potential of data and what data can bring on the table.
Then came in Flipkart's first institutional investor, Axel Partners, that put in money into Singapore's seed round and went on to introduce the team to Manish and Umakant, the five ventures. Today, Singapore's investor roster reads like the who's who of VCs in India, but the targeted insights from the Pi Ventures team have been invaluable.
As a startup, one of the most critical things is to understand what other companies are trying to do in the same space, be it AI, be it healthcare, be it IoT. It's not feasible for a startup to talk with so many co-founders and founders of so many startups. So one thing which has helped us is whenever we had a question about the ecosystem, how the startup ecosystem is evolving around AI, Manish and Umakant have been the go-to person because they do it day in, day out. They have talked with so many startups, they have a good understanding of the space. Additionally, since they have a background on hardware, they have helped us tremendously in that space. So they have introduced us to some very well-known industrial designers whom we are working to, you know, change the design and create a roadmap for evolving our hardware as well.
Well, they know what it takes to start up, and that is probably why it's always entrepreneur first for the Pi Ventures team. With that, it is time for us to wrap up this edition of Young Turks. Next week, we go behind the scenes at the Axelor Startup Accelerator in Bengaluru. But for now, from all of us here on the team, goodbye and many thanks for watching.
Celebrating 16 years of Young Turks.